Well, hi there, and welcome to Card Triple Play. I'm Sandy, and I'm going to show you three cards today. I've used to do this, and I haven't done it in a while, so I usually do a kind of okay card, a better, and a best, just so that we kind of get an idea of how to step up our cards and dress them up a little bit. So I wanted to try a one-layer card with this new Great Impressions fundraiser stamp for Operation Right Home. There will be a link in the doobly-doo if you want to go get this or one of the other ones. And I screwed this up as always. I'm a bad stamper. I'm just going to tell you that. I'm going to admit that. I need a 12-step club for stampers who can't stamp like clear images because it takes me a lot of tries to do that. And on this one, I wanted to do a one-layer card and I smudged my ink. I got some partial stamping, just really bad. And then the missing U is even crooked. This is something that happens to me a lot, so I end up using a lot of the back sides of paper to stamp on. But on a one-layer card, that's not going to be very good, especially because this is really wussy cardstock. It's really wimpy cardstock. I'm not even sure if it could qualify as cardstock. So I wanted to see if I could make a one-layer card with this stamp that would be great. And here it is. This one, let me show you the cardstock first, the difference between them. I'm going to squish both of them vertically, and you can see the one on the right, the wussy one, bows out like that, and the one on the left really doesn't do much. So sometimes our heroes only have their buddy's backpack to use as a table, so we don't want the pen to poke through. So that's why you want heavier cardstock. And these also might be scrapbooked someday, and you want really nice quality stuff for our heroes' families to hang on to forever. Anyway, get back to this card. I stamped it better this time. I really worked hard to make sure my stamp was on straight. And I distress watercolored the image. There's a tutorial that I'm going to point to right up here, and I'll add an annotation so you can go see it, because a couple weeks ago I did a tutorial on distress watercoloring. And I did have to press this in a book for a while before it was flat enough, because the distress watercolor on just one layer gets all kind of wonky, even though the paper is good. When you get any paper wet, it generally gets kind of wobbly. The third one did not work as a one-layer card, partially because Copics go through the paper and they end up with the coloring on the inside of the card, so that's not great. But I also had once again stamped my sentiment a little crooked, so when I put it on the layer, I was able to, you know, when I trimmed it down a little bit, and I was able to nudge it just a little bit in my trimmer to make the sentiment straight on the square or on the rectangle, and then add another rectangle behind it. And I've also popped it with one layer of dimensional adhesive, because one layer is as much as we can do. So I just wanted to share those with you and let you know that you can do one-layer cards if you're very good at stamping straight. I don't do them that much because I'm not. Anyway, I will see you guys tomorrow. Have a really great day. Bye now.